there's an abandoned lot here in my neighborhood about a block from my house. And I've been mowing it for the last 2 years just because it would get overgrown and just look nasty. So I decided instead of mowing it, I was going to see if I could garden on it. I'm the founder of the Urban Garden Experiment. The idea was inspired by the food policy program, the Urban Food Corridor put on by the city in the Bloomberg Foundation competition. And even though we did not win the competition, I thought it was a good idea worth pursuing. And rather than having a bunch of meetings and a lot of talk, I just wanted to start doing. Our partner, the Acadia Landscape, who found us through Facebook, has been instrumental in this program. We've got 108 tomatoes so far. We've got 18 eggplants, 18 squash, 18 zucchini, 18 broccoli, 18 peppers, a box full of herbs, and I've recently got some pumpkins and cucumbers donated. Well, I'm on the board of directors for Redeeming Hope Ministries, a nonprofit, and we have a Food in the Fort program where we have fresh produce that we distribute out to those on the fringes of homelessness but still have access to a kitchen that can prepare the raw vegetables. So some of these vegetables will go to them. And then we've partnered with Slow Food. Slow Food's having a pint for a pint program at Beard and Beer Market. I think they're still working out the details, but in essence, if you bring a pint jar, you can get a pint of beer, and that's going to generate jars, and then Casey's going to use our tomatoes and have a canning demonstration, and the proceeds from the canning class will benefit Redeeming Hope. I think it's going to take off. We went to a tax sale last week, and I was pretty disappointed. We were bidding on three lots, one of which was long and skinny, and we wanted to put a greenhouse on it and possibly use that to start our own seedlings next year to sell in farmers markets, propagate for our own garden, and hopefully put some of our homeless friends to work. It went for more than we could afford. And then there were two lots together that we wanted so that we could have a larger garden that we actually owned on the other side of the Mechanicsville. We got one of the two, and we're trying to negotiate with the people that won the other half to see if they might be interested in selling it to us.